What's up? Conor Dwyer here, chilling in a nice hot day here in Rome, Italy. Getting ready to compete tomorrow at the Energy for Swimming. Team USA has been kicking it here for a week, and we're excited to get this competition going.
Awesome. So y'all have been here for a week. What have you been up to in Rome?
Well, it's been piping hot, usually about 95 to 105 a day here. So we're catching some rays. We're staying hydrated, or at least trying to. Eating a lot of pizza. Pizza reviews, one bite. Everyone knows the rules. Good carb diet, pizza, pasta, and just seeing the sights. It's such a beautiful city, so much history, and a lot of stuff to see.
That's awesome. So of the sights you've seen, which one's been your favorite?
I have to say Colosseum. Big Gladiator fan, top 10 movie of all time for me, so seeing the Colosseum was all time.
That's cool. And so yesterday we spent a little bit of time at the Waldorf. We hit the pool, got a little cold tub in. You said you might do that again today. For those people out there that don't know what it's all about, why is the cold tub so important?
Cold plunge is huge for recovery. I mean, we've been walking around. I think you said you got 25,000 steps in yesterday. So we've been walking a lot. After a competition or after we race or a hard training sesh, try and hit the cold plunge for 5 to 15 minutes. Kind of numbs your legs and brings them back where they're not as sore, you're feeling fresh, and hopefully be able to throw a decent swim down tomorrow.
Nice. So bringing up the swims, what are you racing in?
I'm racing for sure 2 free tomorrow, and then we'll see from there. Everyone on Team USA has kind of been enjoying their time here, not too much training, maybe just extending the taper, kind of a Nathan Adrian type, maybe more out of the water and you'll feel better. So we'll see how it goes.
That's awesome. So you think you can pop a good time tomorrow? We'll see what happens.
We'll see what happens. Kind of just been enjoying myself here. But the facility is beautiful. You've really said they're going to hype up this event. I think we'll have a sold out crowd. There's a junior meet going on the last week. The fans have been packed here at night, so I think it's going to be a good event tomorrow.
That's awesome. And for those people that don't know, tell them what Energy for Swim is all about, what this competition does.
Yeah, this competition is one of the first I think Energy for Swim has put on, hopefully more to come. It's a great event where there's a couple different teams. There's the Energy team, I think an Australian team, USA team, Italian team, and it's overall point system by teams, and the winning team gets to donate to the charity of their choice. So it's a really good event, and I hope they can put on more in the future.
That's awesome. But I mean, for everybody that doesn't know too, I mean, this event's chock full of people. There's like all the biggest names in the world, right?
Yeah, this event is stacked. A lot of the people are coming straight from the World Cups to rip it here. It's probably going to be one of the most loaded resume field in some of these events, like a college dual meet. Just blown out of proportion with Olympic gold medalists left and right competing. So it should be a cool dual meet setting.
Awesome. And final question for you. You've been all over the world to swim. How does Rome rank so far?
Rome's all time. I mean, we're what, 10 minutes out of all the historical stuff in the city, and they have 3 or 4 pools right here. So I'd rank this up there with the best facilities I've ever seen. And a lot of heat here, 100 degrees. We're just soaking in rays left and right.
For sure. And in the background here, we got Mussolini's pool, the old indoor pool. This is the entire Olympic layout from the Rome Olympics. Olympic Stadium off in the distance.
There's some statues. Show those later.
It's amazing. We got the practice pool back here. Great stuff. All right. Thanks, Conor.
Thanks. See ya.